Hey guys, so today we're going to be talking about properties of logarithms, and this is section 3.3. We've already discussed the fact that a logarithm is just an exponent, right? So now let's take a look at what happens when we multiply powers, right? We already know this. We know that 2 squared times 2 cubed is 2 to the power of 2 plus 3, right? So what happens there when we multiply the powers is we add the exponents, right? So if logarithms are just exponents then, right? Let's talk about just exponents. We know from this that the exponents of products of powers, right, is equal to the sum of the products, basically, right? I'm sorry, the sum of the exponents, right? So the exponent of the product of powers is equal to the sum of the individual exponents. Well, let's write that in math. How do I write the exponent of a product of powers? Well, exponent is logarithm. Of a product of powers, that's 2 squared times 2 cubed. Okay, so the exponent of this is equal to the sum of the individual exponents. Well, how do I write the first exponent, the exponent of this? Well, that's just this. Okay, that's the exponent of the first one plus the exponent of the second one. And now look at that. Have you seen that before? You have. You've seen it as a property that says log of A times B is equal to log of A plus log of B, right? Because the exponent of the product of the powers is equal to the sum of the individual exponents. That's all it is, okay? The exponent here is the sum of the individual exponents. And it's the same thing when you're dividing, right? Because then the exponent is the sum of the individual exponents, right? And so here we have the product and the quotient. And then we also have the last of the properties of logarithms that says log of x to the p, right, is equal to what? The p will come down, become a coefficient, and it's just p log x. Okay, let's use that to do some of these problems here. So first I have log base 2 of 32, and I want to write the root 32 as 32 to the 1/2. What is that equal to then? The 1/2 comes down. So I have log base 2 of 32. And this is 1/2. And what's this? The power of 2, that gives you a 32. That's 5. So 5 over 2. All right. Okay, so here I have 3 log 7 49 to the power of 1/6. Okay. 1/6 comes down. So I have 1/6, whoops, times 3, times this, 7 to the power of 2 is 49, so that's just 2. So all that is equal to 1. Who knew? Same thing here. 4 comes down. 4 times 3, ln of e, minus 2 times 2 ln of e. But since ln of e is 1, this is just 4 times 3 minus 2 times 2, 8. Okay. All right. Next, we want to do some expanding. And when we expand, we basically use all of those properties together. Okay. The one thing you have to remember is if you have a product to add and if you have a quotient to subtract. All right, so let's start with this one. This is ln of x squared plus ln of root e. But the 2 will come down, right? So this is 2 ln of x plus ln of e to the 1/2, okay? Which means this is 2 ln of x plus 1/2 comes down, ln of e is 1, so that's that. All right, let's do another one. Okay, look here. I have a log base 6, and this is in the numerator. So, you know, it has a plus sign in front. Now, look at what I have on the bottom. I have a 36 and a y to the 4. Both of those are in the numerator, I'm sorry, are in the denominator. So the rule is anything that's in the denominator gets a minus sign. So here I have minus log base 6 of 36. The y to the 4 is also in the denominator, so minus log base 6 y to the 4. Okay, so I like to do these individually and again, independently of each other. Whatever's on top gets plus, plus, plus. Whatever's on the bottom gets minus, minus, minus. Also, inside the original argument of the log, how many terms do we have? I have 1. I have 2, not terms, but elements. How many elements? I have 1, cube root of x, 2, the 36, 3, the y to the 4. 3 separate elements means I get 3 different terms when I expand the log. 3 different logarithms. Okay, now I need to simplify these. This is log base 6, x to the 1/3. Always write roots as exponents. Minus, this is just a 2, minus 4 comes down here. Okay, at the end of the day, we like to write the constants in front. So this will be negative 2 plus 1/3 comes down. So I have 1/3 log x minus 4 log y. And remember to keep the base, okay? All right. Next, we're going to condense. When you condense, you want to end with one logarithm. Okay? So, first, make all the coefficients exponents. So this will be log base 4, x to the 1/2, minus log base 4, x minus 2 cubed. All right? Equal to. First one is a plus, right? So it's going to be a numerator. So log base 4, x to the 1/2. Next, I have a minus. So that whole thing goes underneath x minus 2 cubed. You can leave it like this, or you can say this is log base 4 root x over x minus 2 cubed. Here, again, all exponents become coefficients. So I have ln x plus 1 to the 6 plus ln, I'm sorry, x plus 1 to the 5 plus ln x to the 6. And that is ln x plus 1 to the 5 times x to the 6. Now, I know some of you are asking, well, wait a minute, can I just skip that middle step and go directly to here? Yes, you can. All right, that's a step that's allowable to skip. Okay? All right, that much about logarithms. Now, the next thing we're going to do is something that's not explicitly covered in our textbooks. However, it is extremely important in calculus, and often when students go into calculus at whatever level, they can do the calculus parts of it fine, but when it comes to this stuff, you know, which is more algebra-ish, they kind of struggle because the curriculum hasn't done a good enough job reinforcing or teaching these. So here's my step to undo that. All right. What we're going to do here is factor. Okay. I know you guys know how to factor. This is, you know, factoring taken up a couple of notches. Okay. Extreme factoring, if you will. All right. All right. So look at the first one. I have 2x e to the x squared minus 6 e to the x squared. Here, we're going to factor out a monomial, right? You notice here, what do they have in common? They both have e to the x squared in common. So I'm going to take out e to the x squared. When I take out e to the x squared, right, here's what I have left. So e to the x squared. And now some of you are probably saying, wait, Miss Malikian, can't you also take out a negative? You can. You can also take out a negative. All right. And what else can you take out? A 2, right? So you can also take out a negative 2, right? So we can take out a negative 2 e to the x squared. And now we have to factor this. So let's take a moment, right, and think about what it is that we do when we factor. If you have x to the 7 plus x cubed, and you want to factor that, well, we know that you take out x cubed, and then what do you have left? X to the 4 plus 1. How do you know that that's what you have left? What did you do in order to get x to the 4 plus 1 from x to the 7 plus x cubed? You didn't think about this. Right? But subconsciously, because you were factoring out the x cubed, you divided each of those terms by x cubed, didn't you? Yep, that's how you got x to the 4 plus 1. So here too, when we're factoring out negative 2 e to the x squared, I'm going to divide each of those terms by negative 2 e to the x squared. So in the first one, the negative 2s cancel, the e to the x squares cancel, and all I got left is an x, minus, in the second one, e to the x squared, and then you divide negative 6 by negative 2, so you just get positive 3. Okay? And that is what we factored right there. Okay. Next, what can I factor out of this one? Well, I can factor out an x and, ooh, what about the e's? Okay, I can definitely factor out an x. Why do I know to factor out an x and not an x squared? Because between the two of them, I take the one with the lower exponent. So now I have e to the negative 4x and e to the negative x. Which one of those is smaller, negative 4x or negative x? Well, negative 4x is smaller, so that's what I need to factor out. Which means I divide each of these by x e to the negative 4x. X e to the negative 4x. Okay, let's see what we got here. In the first case, 1x cancels with 1x. I have 5. X left over, the e's go away, minus x's go away. I have 2, but what about the e's? I got e to the power of negative x minus negative 4x. So finally, I have x e to the negative 4x times 5x minus 2e to the 3x. All right, isn't that something? Okay, let's do another one. All right, things are getting a little interesting here. Look at this. What do I have in common? An x plus 1, right? So I'm going to factor out an x plus 1. But also, look at the e's. E to the x minus 2, e to the x, and here I have an x missing. We're going to make that e to the x. Okay, so please, let's go ahead and do that. So between e to the x and e to the x minus 2, I factor out e to the x minus 2. That means for each one of these, I'm going to divide by these. Okay, x plus 1, e to the x minus 2, x plus 1, e to the x minus 2. Okay, let's see what I have left. First term, these go away. I have a 7 left. Plus, I have a 2. E to the power of x minus 2. Plus, these go away. E to the power of x minus 2. Okay, so I have x plus 1, e to the x minus 2, 7 plus 2. What do I have here? E to the 2 plus, same thing here, e to the 2. Now, finally, that's x plus 1, e to the x minus 2, times 7 plus 2e squared plus another e squared is 3e squared. Okay? All right. It looks like I kind of ran out of room there. All right, let's do another one. Okay. Look at what we got here. I can factor out a 3x and an e to the power of negative 1/2. That's what I got missing, right? So 3x e to the negative 1/2, 3x e to the negative 1/2. Do you have to write the division every single time? You don't. If you can do it in your head, that's fine. But if you need it in the beginning as a guide, please do. Okay. Anything to keep us sane, right? So here, everything cancels out. I have a 1 plus 9x over 3x is 3. E to the, subtract the exponents, 1/2 minus negative 1/2. So this is 3x, e to the negative 1/2, 1 plus 3e to the 1. But now I have another problem. I can't have negative exponents. So I write this as 3x, 1 plus 3e over e to the 1/2. Okay? And you can either do e to the 1/2 or you can do root e. It doesn't matter. You just can't have a negative exponent. All right, let's do a couple more. Here, we're going to factor out 4 minus x squared to the power of negative 1/2. Okay. This time I want to show you what happens if you don't do the division, if you don't write out the division. All right, what I get here is 4 minus x squared, I'm dividing these, right? So it's got to be 1/2 minus negative 1/2. Minus x squared. Here, 4 minus x squared to the negative 1/2. The whole thing gets divided out, so I have nothing left. Okay, now what do we got here? This is 4 minus x squared to the negative 1/2. And in here I have 4 minus x squared to the 1 minus x squared. But I gotta do a little bit of simplifying. Okay, this one is 4 minus x squared to the negative 1/2, and eventually that's gonna move down, times 4 minus x squared minus another x squared 4 minus 2x squared. And then finally, this has a positive exponent, stays up there. But the other one has an exponent of negative 1 half, moves to the bottom. So I get root 4 minus x squared. Okay? Very, very calculus-y this one, all right? Okay, we have another one. And if you feel like you got this, you don't have to listen to the next example. You can just skip ahead. I'm going to factor out 2x plus 3 to the negative 1/3. So here I'm going to get a 1 minus 2x plus 3 to the power of 1/3 minus negative 1/3. Okay, this is 2x plus 3 to the 1/3 times 1 minus 2x plus 3 to the power of 2/3. So I can't do much more with that. But then this is a negative here. So I do have to move it below and make it a denominator. So I get 1 minus 2x plus 3 to the 2/3 over 2x plus 3 to the 1/3. And those don't cancel because on top you have 1 minus something, where in the bottom you don't. Okay. Last but not least, we want to rewrite each of these as a product of two powers. Okay? So same thing, but we're going to work backwards. If you had e to the 4 times e to the 3, how do you write them? You would do e to the 4 plus 3, right? Similarly, if you had e to the a times e to the b, how do you write them? E to the a plus b. Well, if we can go in that direction, can we also go in the opposite direction? If I give you e to the a plus b, can you say, oh, that came from e to the a times e to the b? Well, we can now. So take a look at this. I have e to the x plus 4. I want to rewrite this and write it as e to the x times e to the 4. That's it. Okay? And then check, when you multiply that out, do you get that? Yes, you do. Okay? Next, I have e to the negative cosine x times e to the ln of 4, right? We're adding those exponents, so it's times. But what did we just say? We can't have negative exponents. So we're going to do e to the ln of 4 over e to the cosine x. And this is going to be e to the ln of 4 is 4 over e to the cosine x. Now, that's acceptable. Or for this one, you could actually leave it as e to the negative cosine x times 4, which will be 4 e to the negative cosine x. The reason why you can actually leave the negative up there is because it's a variable. So we don't know if it's positive or negative. So sometimes it could be positive, sometimes it could be negative. So either of these will work. All right, last one. This is like straight out of calculus, this one, all right? We actually did it last week in AP Calc. So this one, we write it as e to the kt times e to the, and that's that. We're just going to leave it like that, right? You can leave it like that, or you can write e to the c, e to the kt. It doesn't matter, okay? All right, we will stop here for today. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day.